Tulloch. Okay, it says it's part of Samba. Oh no, it's Samba. I thought it said it was part of Samba before. Anyway, it looks like it's separate, so let's download this. Alright, okay, I've gone back to my home directory, haven't I? CD sources. So we've got all these dependencies and we can build it. That looks successful, so let's check it. So that looks okay. Let's install it. Looks like that's done. So that's under general libraries. Tulloch. So now we can build. Oh, let's clean this one up. Downloaded. Oh, what happened there? Save link as. Oh, that's strange. Oh, is it taking its time? Looks like another one of these that's stuck. That's probably why the Linux from scratch team have mirrored it. So I'm gonna quit this to get rid of this window. Let's try Alt F4. No, that doesn't work. Let's try kill. Alright, that's killed the whole lot. Hopefully we haven't lost our tabs. No, luckily. Sources, BLFS. So let's save this copy here. Pop, so that's better. So there's no special config commands. Let's configure and make it. And Doxygen to build some documentation. Run make check. It's all my past. And make install and install the API as well, API documentation. So that's another one for general libraries. Pops, wasn't it? So libnsl, PSVT, yeah, we've got these. So nothing fancy here, just copy and paste again. Sudo su and install it. That's done. So that's 17 libnsl. Now we're going to install bind. So we've got that one. We've got these, got all this, NetDNS, this is a module, yeah, it's a Perl module. Let's see if we haven't downloaded that already. NetDNS, no we haven't, okay. So let's grab this. Let's build it and install it. Sure if this has got stuck. Let's have a look. Yes, it's hung the looks of it. Let's abort it and start it again. Let's try and make one string one test if that makes a difference. looks like that's hanging. We'll give it another minute or so. Oh, it just moved on then. Okay, looks like it's doing nothing, but it is. So I'll give this one a few more minutes then, this time, just in case. Okay, well that eventually did run. It was very slow. It was probably timing out by the looks of it. So maybe it was me just being a bit impatient. So let's install that. Looks like it was all okay. That's done. So it looks like the rest of it is ready to be installed now. Okay, we've already downloaded it. To ensure bind build DN set key manager installed Python module as root user. Okay. Install bind running followed commands. Okay, so I can see already there's something we want to add. We want to add the IDN2 because we've installed that. Yep. Enable fetch limit. Use this option you want to enable to limit the rate of recursive current client queries. I don't think that's going to be a problem in an environment like this, especially in a single machine. Disable Linux caps. TLZ. So don't know what that is, so I'll leave that. So I think I'll just take those options there. Okay, so let's build this. Right, so as root, we've got to bring up some test interfaces. And now we can run make check. It's an unprivileged user, so let's run that and wait for it to finish. Okay, so that testing was successful. We now need to take the network interfaces down. And then install the package. So we need to create a user for bind and set up some files and directories. Just generate a key and then create a config file. And a zone. And a hint. So this must be updated periodically with the utility. So there's something here to put in your own domain, your own valid domain name. So I haven't got that, so I'm not put that in. Set permissions. And we need to do make install bind. Now I'm hoping this is not going to affect any name resolution, so if it does, I'm going to have to stop the server from running. So let's go to sources, BLFS, boot scripts, make install bind, etc, init, bind, start. So let's tell us, this will probably fail because we haven't got a proper domain. It's come out with my server actually. I've already got a DNS server running, so I'm not sure if that's a good thing or not. That's still working, so that's alright. So that is complete. Major servers, chapter 20. So we'll shut that one down. And we'll go on to this Python module cryptodome. To the Python directory, okay, still downloading. This seems to be taking quite a while. Okay, it's nearly there. Just very, very slow. Okay, it's done. I'm meant to move it actually. So we build this for Python 2 and 3. So that's done, let's install both of them. Let's do the same for 3. And that's done. So we've got another Perl module. I don't remember this one being installed. So usual Perl build instructions, and sudo mighty make install. That's done. So now we're in a position to build Samba. So, since remember we downloaded it before, maybe we didn't. No, maybe we didn't. I thought we had done. So this won't take too long. It's downloaded 8 meg and it's 18 meg. Okay, I'll give it another minute or so. It's done. So first we've got to fix the test always fails. And then we've got probably load, oh no, there's not too many config commands. And FHS. This is something without ADDC. Okay, self-test prefix equals. So we're going to specify test. So that's two. Okay, I don't think we need that. So we can just copy the config and make as it is. Okay, so that's finished compiling. There's two tests to run. I'm going to run both and the quick one first, just for general sanity test, and then the extended one to see how well we do with that. So let's run the first one. Sorry, not sudo test, but I'm going to time it. Okay, so that really was quite quick. Everything's passed, so now I'm going to run the biggie with make test. It says it takes 290 SBUs, so it'll be interesting to see how long it really does take. It does say it's not recommended for the average builder, so yeah, if this is your first time or you just do this on ad hoc, then you probably don't want to run it, but I'm going to run it and see what happens. Okay, so that's failed after just half an hour. Maybe. Oh, it looks like it has finished. So again, I'd say probably SPU is a bit doubtful. We can have a look at this file here. See if there's anything useful in it. Five errors there. Let's see if there's a summary. No. All right, okay, looks like there's only 35 there. I presume that's another test there. Another one there, and then these are unknown tests, they're all skipped, so I think we did a little bit better than what it says as well. 73 errors and 30 failures, so I don't think that's too bad. Right, so let's install it now. It's done a bit about configuration here. Wish to print to a printer attached to an SMB. Let's create a back-end device, so let's create that in case you want to do that. And then it's how we want to use it. Guess I could set up a print server. So I'll just take these defaults. I'm not going to even bother to check to see if they work or not. Not particularly interested in setting it up exactly. What I'm going to do though is create an smb.conf and insert this information here. There's two services here. I guess I could start them both, although, oops. Probably wouldn't ever want a window domain service, but you never know, you might want to install that. So make install Samba and then bind D. And let's start both of them. And they seem to have started without complaining, so whether or not they've actually done anything or not. Not really bothered. Obviously, if this was a real machine I was using, then I'd take a bit more care in what I was doing. So that's completed Samba. And we'll move on to FFmpeg. It might be a good idea to reboot and just let everything settle again. Not FFmpeg, that's going to be known, wasn't it? Yeah, I'll just let this reboot. Also check the boot scripts are working correctly. Everything seems to start alright, apart from obviously the Kerberos.